Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Hello guys, my name is Afni Susan, ID number 12010320954. I'm from Islamic Education Management.
Here, I will explain about the beginning and ending. You will learn how to address someone whether you know them, don't know them, or don't even know their name. Pay attention to detailed example, Mr., Doctor, and Professor. Make it clear how your email is intended for and use standard English phrases rather than translating directly from your own language. 1. Spell the recipient name correctly. Make sure your recipient name is spelled correctly. Think how you feel when you see your own name is misspelled. Some names in squid action. Look at the author, person, signature, and cut and paste it into the beginning of your email. That's why you will not make any mistake either in spelling or in using of actions. 2. Use an appropriate initial salutation and be careful with yourself. If you have had no communication with the person before, then it is always best to use their title. Also, even if professor means replies to your email and thanks himself as John, this style best to continue using professor means until he says, for instance, please feel free to call me John. 3. Avoid problems when it is not clear if the recipient is male or female, or with is their surname. In addition, many English first names seem to have no clear indication of the sex. For example, Saxon, Adair, Candler, and Chelsea. And some English names can be for both me and woman, for example, June, Sam, Chris, and Hillary. In some cases, it might not be clear to you which is the person first and last name, for example, Stewart James. 4. Be as specific as possible when addressing an email to someone whose name you do not know. For important email, it is as always best to find out the name of the person to address. This maximizes the chances of your email reaching the right person, being opinions and being responded. 5. Remind the recipient who you are when previous contact has only been brief. You can announce your name and what you mean. My name is Heidi Muller, and you may remember that I came up to you after your presentation yesterday. I asked you the question about X. Well, I was wondering. 6. Use standard phrases rather than translation from your own language. Every language has certain phrases that cannot be translated literally into its natural language. Using standard phrases enables you to be sure that at least the beginnings and ends of your email are correct. Then in the body of the email, it is advisable not to experiment. 7. Begins with a greeting plus recipient names. If you begin an email simply with hi or good morning, or with no greeting at all, it will not help the recipient know if the message really was intended for them.
8. If there has been no previous contact, give reason for your email immediately. Begin by explaining your reason for writing rather than giving your name, which the recipient will have already seen before even opening your email. 9. Indicates to multiple recipients who actually needs to read the mail. If someone is on a mailing list, they may receive hundreds of emails that are not specifically for them. It is hard good practice to begin your email by saying who exactly the email. Thanks. Make it clear who shall read your email and what it is you are requesting. The reason for your email shall be clearly stated as early as possible in the email. So Kim Call have begun his email like this.
11. Avoid templates for beginnings and endings. This kind of semi-automatic email is unlikely to create marks of a relationship with the recipient. However, I recognize that it is first of deference and efficiency.
12. If in doubt how to own your email, use BuzzRegard. There are many ways of ending an email in English, but the simplest is BuzzRegard. You can use this with practically anyone, whether you have met them before or not. 13. Don't use a sequence of standard phrases in your email salutation. Bear in mind that many people in academy receive up to 100 emails a day. Thus, they do not have time to read such a long series of salutations.
14. Ensure your signature contains everything that your recipient may need to know. What you include in your signature has some effect on the recipient's perception of who you are and what you do. It is generally a good idea to include most or all of the following. 15. Avoid PSS and anything under your signature. When receiving your salutation, example, BuzzRegard or name, it is a signal for them to stop reading.